Welcome to VF Audio, the audio edition of Vanity Fair, featuring select articles from the magazine's August issue. This edition includes the following stories. Track 2, Morality Tales, by Graydon Carter. Vanity Fair's editor introduces this month's issue. Track 3, The Prince of Wales Turns One, by Katie Nicol. As Prince George turns one, the author chronicles the future king's first year. Track 4, Christie World, by Brian Burrow, an investigation of the scandal that could cause a detour in New Jersey Governor Chris Christie's path to the White House. Track 5, VF Portrait, Thomas Keller, by Alice Waters. As Keller celebrates 20 years at his California restaurant, The French Laundry, another culinary star recalls one of the greatest meals of her life at his New York outpost, Per Se. Track 6, Out to Lunch with Samantha Power, by John Helper. The UN ambassador on negotiating playdates and power. Track 7, The Pink and Green Blues, by Mark Seal. The author reports on the boycott and backlash at the Beverly Hills Hotel. Track 8, To Capture Claridge's, by Dana Vachon. The author investigates the bitter feud over ownership of the preeminent London hotel, Claridge's. Track 9, In the Details, by Leslie M.M. Bloom. What you should know about Danny Meyer, the culinary world's busiest CEO. Track 10, No, No, Ninettes, by James Wolcott. As the 90s nostalgia boom continues, the author discusses how nostalgia itself has changed. Track 11, Elsa Peretti's Great Escape, by James Reginato. 40 years into her partnership with Tiffany, the author finds the jewelry designer in her element. For more stories, including vivid photography, buy the full issue on newsstands. Visit vf.com or download digital editions at vf.com/app.
The good people of New Jersey have historically had a soft spot for tough guys. This being the case, Chris Christie, a Republican, would seem to be their dream idea of a governor. Larger than life, or at least larger than most governors, he developed an image as a quick, straight-talking politician who could get things done and who, on the surface at least, played well with others. Even Democrats were expected to get behind him for his re-election. His supporters were drawn to his no-nonsense way of governing and his combative style of negotiation, as when he shouted down teachers and other public workers in town hall meetings, events that were filmed by his staff and then posted on YouTube. That sort of confrontational politics, though, could also be read as threatening and even bullying. As VF special correspondent Brian Burrow, himself a longtime resident of New Jersey, recounts in Christie World, those who ran afoul of the governor tended to feel like short-lived extras on The Sopranos. They wouldn't wind up with cement shoes or anything so obvious or camp. The Christie machine was more subtle than that. Promised funding for a pet project might be mysteriously held up or canceled altogether. Relatives on the public payroll were told that their services were no longer in demand. For Mark Sokolich, the mayor of Fort Lee, a small bedroom community on the Palisades above the Hudson River, snubbing Christie didn't affect him so much as it did the people in his town. Back in late 2013, Sokolich, a Democrat, made the grievous mistake of resisting the Christie camp's entreaties for an endorsement for the governor's re-election. It wasn't long before Christie's operatives turned the streets of Fort Lee into a parking lot by blockading entrance lanes to the George Washington Bridge, which happens to be the busiest bridge in the world. Inasmuch as the lanes funneled traffic from Fort Lee into Manhattan, this created the expected mayhem. Traffic backed up, school buses had trouble getting kids to school, and ambulances were delayed in reaching their patients. The closures were part of a traffic study, as Christie's associates termed it, and it might have gone on much longer had journalists from the Bergen Record and the Wall Street Journal not begun nosing around. They started asking questions, thereby alerting a courageous 79-year-old state senator.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.